Dr. Doreen Grandpichet
is a visionary in the field of autism. Now you can ask her questions on Ask Dr. Doreen.
Terry says, I'm trying to sort out homeschooling. That's a hard thing, but we have a bunch of, I wonder if there's a way that we can post it. We have a page of over 100 educational apps that are, a lot of them are free right now or very low cost, or have at least a free version where they have pop-up ads, but you weigh what you need. Some of them are, it's a free trial for 14 days. I'm gonna see if we can find a way that we can post that for you guys, because we have a list that we're working up, but there are a lot of really great things. And I wanna hear from you, Dr. Grandpichet, too, but we're having a lot of people that say that the school is dishing out is not edible for their kids in terms of educational programming. But there's a lot of online curriculum, especially Khan Academy, khanacademy.org. It's all curriculum aligned, but it's paced differently a lot of times. And it's from pre-K through graduate work. A lot of times that can be beneficial for our kids. But Bonnie Yates was with us the other day and said, just document the hey, nani, nani. If the school is giving you something that isn't working, make sure that you're keeping a journal about what you've had to switch to, that you started using Khan Academy instead of what they were giving, so that later on when things are better, you can ask for remediation and ask for tutors if your child needs to be caught up, if and when that needs to be done. But Dr. Grandpichet, anything you want to add to that?
Yeah, thank you. And that's very good advice from Bonnie. There's two quick things. One is that a couple days ago, I was going through and trying to help our clinical team develop as many activities, I guess, for our BTs, our behavior techs, as possible. So, and as you know, Shannon, where in most cases when we're funded through an insurance company or that type of payer, we're not allowed to do academic work, right? So most of the work that we do is not academic in nature. However, our curriculum does have an academic portion. We built an academic portion that we also have a lot of school contracts. So for those of you who are on skills, you can find academic programming on that, on skills. There's a whole domain called academic and you can go in there and there's tons and tons of worksheets and activities and lessons and so on. That's first. Second, as I was looking at all these, I was trying to just find old things and I went back and I realized that back in the day, you know, when you've done this for like 30, 40 years, you have a lot of material you can count on is still somewhere. So yeah. At some point in the past, I think probably about 20 years ago or maybe something around there, we had at CARD made thousands of worksheets, thousands, literally. And we ended up actually putting some of those on skills lessons, but a lot of them we just had in binders at the various sites. And so they kind of fell to the side. I was fortunate to go back and find all of those worksheets on our servers. And so there's thousands, literally maybe 10,000 worksheets. And a lot of them, or at least a third of them, maybe a quarter of them are academic skills. So they're reading worksheets, writing, mathematics, et cetera, worksheets. And I just forwarded all of those links to our clinical team, Shannon, Dennis's team, your team.
Wow.
Basically said, this was last weekend, and I basically advised them which sections to look for. But if you don't mind, if you send an email to Cecilia, or if you talk to her, she has access. And what they could do is they can pull all the academic stuff that we're not otherwise using for our BTs and just send those to all of our families, all of our viewers. There's literally thousands of them. So I would be happy to send those over to all of our parents. Yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. Thank you for that.
Hey. Hey, thanks for watching Autism Live. To subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to check out some more of our videos, click here.